It's time for beer googles, boys and girls. Chris's shot is with tequila, because I'm gonna drink vodka instead of him. As soon as we mix the drinks, we're gonna puke all over the place. Time to drink. Thank you, Chris. Hold on for shots.
Yay! Yep.
Welcome, everybody. It's beer googles time. It's beer googles 30. Let us drink. I drink the vodka. You drink the tequila. Because it's tequila.
It's going to be a long day.
It's going to be a long day, my friend. Cheers.
Salud.
We drink.
Salud.
Oh, Danny boy. Oh, Danny boy. The drinks are calling.
Is Dan Aykroyd Irish?
Probably not. He's probably Aykroydian.
Is that a planet?
I think he's a conehead. Isn't he? Isn't he an alien? He's like, meow.
Yes. Take me to your leader.
Take me to your leader. So, boys and girls, today. Hey, sir, what are we talking about today?
Today's podcast is the 10 worst sounds in the universe.
Or just the number of them. I don't even think we have numbers.
I think we have 14. No, yeah, we have like a number. 8. Yeah.
So, something came up where we were talking about, and it came up annoying sounds. Like, want to hear the most annoying sound in the world? And no, we don't want to hear that. So we're not going to do that. But there have been noises that come across. And I came across this weird topic because we are beer googles. We get drunk and look up random shit on the internet. That's just what we do, people.
That's kind of our job.
And we I found this thing called misophonia.
Shut up.
Misophonia is like a it's now a psychiatric event or psychiatric or psychological event of people who can't stand noises.
Like a disorder?
Yeah, it's actually kind of a disorder now. It's being looked at like a disorder. Like anytime you hear like, you know, we're going to go through all the sounds, but, you know, think of annoying sounds that you hear in your life and go, oh, God, stop that. You're sitting at your desk at work and some moron's doing X, Y, or Z. And you're like, please stop.
Ooh, I have a question.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, pick me.
Sir, Mr. Peralta in the back. In the back.
So, pick me.
Teacher.
I have a question.
Christopher, please. Yeah, yes, Christopher.
So, if this DB at work.
Yes.
His voice makes me want to vomit in my mouth. Do I have misophonia?
Sure.
Misophonia?
Yeah, you have misophonia.
Misophonia?
Misophonia, yes, you do.
Misophonia?
Yeah.
Does that mean I can never go to work again and still get paid?
Will
you be my, are you my witch doctor? Can you write me a prescription for that?
I could be your witness saying, yes, he does have an annoying voice.
Yeah, one time he walked in the door behind me and he was so loud, I jumped in my, literally, I was, you may be having performance issues. Oh, we fixed it.
Allegedly, we have performance issues.
Whoa,
I've never had performance issues like that.
We need to take some blue pills up in here.
Can you start shoving blue pills up that camera's butt? Is it a prophylactic? Open up. Okay, so this guy's
so the guy walks in and he goes, and I went, I literally was startled out of my seat. I swear.
Just turn around and be like, self-defense. Boom.
Yeah, I have like a ruler. That's it. That's all I got, man. So I 10 minutes later, I started packing up my stuff and I moved discs. But I have mesophiliomia.
You've got some kind of omia, no, Nina. So I believe, just to correct the term for all our beer Google friends out there, I believe it's misophonia. M-I-S-O-P-H-O-N-I-A, misophonia. I move on to the next round of the spelling bee.
Oh, my goodness.
Thank you. And I'm a white guy who's moving on. How does that happen? White guys don't know how to spell for shit.
I didn't.
Shit. S-H-I-P. Oh, damn it.
That's ship.
So close. See, I can't spell
totally
right.
Shipwrecked, man.
So, Chris, you and I went through all these fucking sounds, and we started going back and forth. And we've got a list, and we've got some sounds. So I think we should just get right into it.
Do it.
All right. So I think I shared the last time we shared a story. Oh, go.
What?
You had some?
No, I was anxiously anticipating number one.
We were talking about growing up, I played a woodwind instrument. I believe you also played a woodwind instrument.
Yes, I did.
It was the?
Alto saxophone.
And I believe I played the tenor saxophone.
Yes, sir, that's correct.
Last
we're
time
like two Kenny G's up in here, man.
Oh, Careless Whisper again.
Tell it to my heart.
Wasn't that on the, tell it to the 80s no. program?
It was.
That's Taylor Dane, bro.
I know, I just wanted to sing
I love Taylor
Dane.
Dane. She's great. She's the other Taylor. She's T Dizzle. she's pre Taylor. So we were going through all these sounds, and you and I played the saxophone, and I told this story about how you have to put your teeth, your front two teeth, on the mouthpiece with the reed on the
which
bottom.
Is the top is plastic.
Yes.
The bottom like is wood.
Yeah. Yes, a wood or a thin piece of, it's the reed, whatever it's made, bamboo or wood.
When we were little, there was wood.
It's wood,
now it's,
right.
Now it could be different.
I thought it was bamboo. I didn't even know, though. But it was
which
whatever.
Is wood, right?
Yeah, yeah. It's a plant, bro. All right? It's wood. It wasn't this wood. You know,
well, hey, it's not.
Oh, the camera's got wood now because we fed it my Viagra because it was
boiling.
Because it was performing inadequately.
The camera has an erection.
So when I bit down on the top part, the vibrations of the saxophone went into my teeth and throughout my body, and I would get instant, like, what's that called? Goosebumps. And every time I hear a sound like that. Now, unfortunately, I didn't have the sound of the saxophone. I looked far and wide, people, but I do have this one.
Wide and far.
Are you ready for the sound?
Okay.
Sound number one?
No, I have many questions.
Okay.
How long did you play the tenor?
A few years, two, three
and,
years.
Okay, so for 2.666 years, you got that sound every time you played? Like,
I got that feeling because
the
vibration.
The feeling.
Yeah.
You got that every day.
Every note that played resonated through my teeth into my body. I can't explain it.
Every day?
Tried the little pad thing. I tried like putting a glue thing on top. None of it works. But I'm German. What am I going to go against my parents?
Yeah,
no,
you
I'm
take the sax, you throw it off the school bus.
No, I just suppress all my feelings and then lash out at them at some other
you
later time.
Shove it down?
Yes.
And that's why you drink Dan Aykroyd's vodka?
Yes. As a matter of fact, this may be a trigger. Shit.
It's a trigger. Oh, welcome to therapy.
I'll get yours first. Hold on. Yeah, I take your shit. Yeah, so I would just play and I hated it. Every second of it. Every motherfucking second of it.
What instrument did Checkmark play in the marching band?
Checkmark, he played with the baton. I like baton in both. It feels good.
Oh, dear. No, gosh.
Yeah, that's how it was. He went. I don't
was
know,
it
bro.
Flaming?
He was afterward. Hey-oh.
I withdraw the questions, man.
I withdraw the answer, but we don't edit. We have to self-police, so I'm going to address this right now. That was a joke about flaming and all that. So.
Well, you know how the batons, they light them on fire on the ends. That's
what
I was talking about.
I know what you're talking about, but if you put it up, you're probably a flamer. See?
That's not what I was talking about, but okay.
Okay. Well, I screwed up then.
All okay, right, well,
so other questions.
That was it. I was just curious how long you played, and did you get that every single time, like every day?
Every day. Practicing, playing, you name it. And I sucked at it.
Jesus.
How about you? Did you ever get that at
no.
all?
No.
Like, you didn't even feel it? Did you ever put your teeth on the thing, or did you do your lips around the outside so it cushioned it like a... I wish you guys had all video, because you see us making an ass of
yourself. Yeah, I put my teeth on the top part, the plastic, whatever. I don't know what that's called.
I call it a resin, like the mouthpiece is what I call it, because the bottom piece was a reed, or the top piece was a mouthpiece.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't bite down on it, but yeah. Yeah, and then you put your teeth on the wood underneath the reed made of bamboo wood. Yeah.
I have fucking idea what it was, bro.
It was a wood byproduct. I don't know.
So I'm just going to say, any kind of woodwind sound that's dissonant, hair stand up on my. I showed it to you earlier. I'm gonna try to show it to you on TV. I'm gonna try to hold it close to show my hair stand up, but it's almost impossible. But are you ready for sound number one?
Yes. So excited.
That was that.
I think you need to replay. Hit it two more times.
Those are my two. Oh God, there they are. Okay, that I'm so glad we got that one out of the way. No more. Stop.
okay. Stop. People are gonna hang up, bro. People are gonna stop. They're gonna stop listening.
Okay. You're an asshole. Wait till you hear the one, the sound of me shitting on your head, but it's not just gonna be a sound. Bro. Yes? That is not a poop joke.
That was not a poop. You said shitting on my head.
But I didn't. It's totally different. I didn't make a poop joke. Like, I'm not talking about, as we did on the last one, by the way, I owe $10 to boxerlove.org. I owe that to you today. I will present it to you at the next podcast.
You can just log on to their site and say donate.
No, because you have to, it's through you, sir. You called me out on it. So you have to make a donation. I just give you the money. That's another one. But no, okay, I am allowed to say I'm going to shit on your head. But if I were to say something like...
No, let's just move on.
Move on. So, misophonia sound number one, clarinet. Or woodwind instrument.
Woodwind.
That's dissonant.
We need to come back to that.
Do we play one more? Do we do a top 10 at the end? Do we go through them all? Or how do we
No, because you're going to fucking freak out if we keep playing that thing again.
I know, bro. I'm about to like jump out that window.
Let's just not... replay the woodwinds. I think we should say the word woodwind every time we do a shot, because at the end it's gonna be like
I like the woodwinds.
It's gonna turn into I don't like marching band.
Clarinet good. So that's my so that was the bane of my childhood, was the hearing any sound. Now anytime I hear like band saxophone, careless whispers about as far as I can go, but other than that, that's it.
What about that dude that was on Instagram that he was all famous? The guy that just walked around the mall,
yeah,
and playing get on tables whisper. And playing. I love that dude.
Have you seen the chat roulette guy of the guy who does like wrecking ball?
No,
I can't wait to show you that
chat roulette.
Yeah, have you ever heard of chat roulette?
No.
Okay, chat roulette was an old masturbation site. Oh, sorry. Well, that's not true. It was just used to masturbate. It's not actually the intent. The intent was that you have a camera on your thing, and you're on this program.
What do you mean have
roulette.
A camera on your thing?
On your computer, right? And a microphone. You have a camera and a microphone, and you go on to chat roulette and you click it, and it randomly goes to anyone else on chat roulette, and shows the video on the other side. 99 times out of 100, it's a dude jerking off. 99 times out of 100, the 100th time, you might find something interesting. In this case, it's this guy who goes on chat roulette playing a song, and he dresses up like in a bikini, and he does like a song, and then they show the reaction of the people who click on him by accident and see him doing this. Like, it's pretty funny. I'm laughing because it is funny. Okay. Yeah, I can't believe you never heard of chat roulette, bro. You've been single.
I also never heard of two chicks in a cup. Let's move along.
Oh, I didn't say that one, bro.
Fucking psycho.
Okay. So misophonia sound number one. I hope
dude,
you stay on
so,
your,
your face is so fantastic.
Oh my god. It just
oh dude, it's just great, man. Oh, I love it.
I can't. It's just okay.
Yes.
Your turn. None of these are as bad as that one. So I had to get that one. I did not.
That's yours.
That
I don't give a shit about that.
Okay, great.
That doesn't bother me at all.
What
I
does
love
bother
it.
You, sir?
What?
What does bother you?
I guess my number one has got to be the cat. First of all, fuck cats. Second of all, it's got to be the cat hairball or cat barfing.
What's that sound like?
Just fucking press it.
Oh, man. All right. Well, do you want everyone want to hear? That would be it. That's your number one?
Fuck.
That is so disgusting. Imagine what's down there that comes up.
I don't have to.
Oh, because you see it after
because I've fucking had a cat, little fucking prick.
You had to clean that shit up, didn't you?
Many times. Get home from work and there's fucking cat barf on the couch.
Yep.
Little fucking dick.
Son of a bitch.
Whore.
It's funny that I'm a cat guy and you're a dog guy. but I don't want any pets, to be honest. I like them. I don't kick dogs or anything. I just don't want to have to take care of them. Cats take care of themselves and then puke hairballs that you have to clean up later, which is
which means they don't take care of themselves because you're emptying the... Okay, let's just not talk about cats anymore.
You know when they give you a gift, that's just letting them know that they can do the same to you. I just want you to know that.
What?
Has a cat ever given you a gift, like left something at your front door? You never had that shit happen?
No.
Cats are notorious for... I had cats.
I understand.
Like, they'll bring like a pigeon or a glove
shit.
Or a string. And they're just like, watch, you're next, bro. That's what they're... That's, it's a warning. It's not a gift.
I know. It's a warning, bro. Fuck them.
They're scary. All right. So my second noise has got to be like dragging a chair across the floor. And it makes that weird squeaky sound. You know what I'm talking about?
Like a metal chair?
Yeah, like a metal or table across the ground.
Isn't that great?
It sounds a little bit something like, well, it's grating, but not great. It's A-T-E, not E-A-T, bro.
You are a good speller for a white guy. Woo! What up, white guy speller? Hashtag white guy speller.
Thank you, drinking. This is what the chair sounds like.
You should do drunk spelling, dude.
Oh, that'd be great. It goes a little something like this, ladies and gentlemen.
That's a weird little dance we could do.
It's the skeevy hair goosebump dance is what I call it. The goosebump dances. It's like the neutron dance from the 80s,
yes,
but totally different.
Doing the neutron dance.
Yeah, the Pointer Sisters, I think.
Yeah, from Beverly Hills Cop 1.
Oh my God.
You are welcome.
Thank you, sir. I wonder if that's not on my list, unfortunately. Although, the thing with Gilbert Gottfried where he's holding the medicine, he's like, I gotta be really careful with this. Oh boy, it's gonna blow up. It's got nitrous in it. Oh, are we not performing correctly? According to the video, it just
camera
doesn't
keeps,
like us right now.
They keep freezing.
That's weird.
I guess we're just too sexy. I'm
too sexy for this sound. Too sexy for this sound. Come going to get me. I'm too sexy for the chair. Too sexy for this chair. So sexy I'm bare.
Don't do it. Woo. Oh, topless guy.
You got underarm. You got armpit.
Oh, gross pit.
Oh, bro. I could show. I could. Oh, Billy.
Oh, Billy.
So that's my number two. How about you, man? What else? What other sound just annoys the fuck out of you?
Besides the guy at work, he's probably my number one. I'd rather listen to a cat barf than that fucking guy.
I asked Megs.
Yes.
And she said, you. And I'm like,
that hurt. You mean me or you?
Not you. Me.
Oh, I was like, she hates me? I was all pissed. I was like, bro, I can't believe she hates me.
But now that you know it's me, you're like, oh, of course.
Well, I'm like, but then my brain goes, then why does she live with you?
Yeah, well.
That's illogical.
I mean, it's me when she doesn't want to hear me, which is like
then
90% of the time.
Then how does she deal with that? This is going to turn into a...
She ignores me. She's a teacher. No, she's a teacher. She just knows how to turn it off. She turns these things off. Like, I can't. These things just close up. I don't know.
Your ears?
She's got a talent. She's special in a non-R way.
Oh, you can't say the S word, dude.
I know.
Special.
What's funny, I'm not going to get into it today, not on this channel, but yeah, I'm still having a hard time trying to get away from that.
Special?
Yeah, special.
You're going to pay for that, boy.
I am. I've already paid for this. We're already drawing up the divorce papers as we speak, and we haven't even gotten married. It's pretty cool. Well, yeah, we're writing the divorce papers first. We're doing it backwards because then that we'll know. Like we're working. It's like reverse engineering a problem. So you don't get married in the first place because you know that's where the problem started.
Like,
because you can't get divorced unless you get married. So if
you
reverse
have a time
engineer,
machine.
Right? If you reverse engineer your start with the divorce, you're like, well, shit, you have to get married. We'll just not do that. Done. How isn't that genius?
You're a freaking smart dude.
That's what I hear, man.
And you're a good speller.
Spieler, yes, I spiel very well. So chair dragging is my two. So we've got. Any kind of woodwind dissonance and chair dragging. We've got your boss who
he's not a boss. He's no.
Oh, he's just a dickwad.
He's a huge dickwad from a sister division.
Oh, that's why, because he's from your fucking sister company.
No, he's like he's in the same building.
That doesn't mean anything.
He's just a loud fuck. Ugh.
Hey, fuck! Cut it down. Shut it. We need you here. Okay, you're here. We need you like what's barely in the screen, right? There.
It's not possible. It's just not possible.
Okay.
It's that's what we need. It's just not possible.
And then the second sound for you was the cat going,
cat barfing.
All right. Yeah. Because you know what's coming after that is the actual ball itself.
Yeah.
Like, it's not only, it's like the thing anticipates, like, it's the sound's not bad enough.
Yeah.
It's followed by material.
Oh my God. Fuck yeah. Sorry, bro. So hard.
So what's your third? Annoying
sound in the world, Billy. Oh, Billy.
Hey, what's the password?
The password is nipple.
I don't know why I always think that's so funny.
I like when he goes bunk. Blah, 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 blah. No, I will not say that to my mother. I will not say that to my mother as I'm Matthew Broderick. Great movie.
I would say next would be a baby screaming on an aircraft.
I don't have that sound.
You're welcome.
That one didn't even cross my mind, but that is the most fucking annoying.
Hey, let's go on vacation to Florida.
Yes.
Okay, and bring our streaming fucking kids.
Yeah. Hey, let's fly to Vegas with our fucking baby.
Well, Vegas is only an hour. It depends
from
on
here.
If you're coming from New York, it's five.
You know, right.
And then
five and a half,
you know, and obviously the majority of the time, the parents, it's not their intention to annoy 157 people on the aircraft, but you know, and if the baby's sick or teething or whatever, or you're like, fuck, what do? You know, the parents are usually trying to do the best they can.
I'm trying to give them the benefit of the fucking doubt.
I don't want to. I still see baby on board stickers on cars, basically keeping them from driving cautiously, but telling us that we're driving incorrectly.
Oh, okay.
I don't think parents care about annoying people. I bet they're like, we brought life into this world. It's special. So if it's crying a little bit, that's a little price to pay for your inconvenience, for me bringing life into the world.
You sounded like Cable Guy. That was really good.
Did I really?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't think that.
So do we need to start
like
considering the fact that perhaps parents are going to be part of our podcast audience?
Well, the truth is, hello, parents world.
Hello. Hello, Twitter parents world.
The truth is, I'm just messing with you guys, but I did see a face mask that said baby on board. And I'm like, yeah, you're 800 pounds overweight. You're either fat or pregnant. I don't need you to have a mask on that tells me baby on fucking board.
Don't you think that's weird that it said it on her face, though?
Yeah.
Like
she ate it?
Yeah. That's kind of...
It's actually someone I consider I like. Someone I like a friend
but
of
wouldn't it be
wife.
Funnier if it was like on her stomach?
Yes. Wouldn't it
not
be better?
On her face?
Yes. Thank you.
Because that's kind of like...
Yeah. It's a whole other thing, man.
Okay. I won't even tell you the first thought I had because
no, she just ate it.
No, that's not what I thought.
I don't want to know, do I?
It's pornographic.
Ew. I don't... Want anything to do
how
with
did I
baby.
Think of that and you didn't?
I don't even know what
I
you're talking about.
I will owe you $5.
Porn babies are not.
I would owe you $3.
Porn babies are not something I want to talk about.
It's not porn babies.
Oh. Well, okay, then share it, bro.
She swallowed.
Oh, that would be baby in tummy. That's totally different. That's what I'm gonna get a mask
but
says
it's baby on board.
Potential baby in tummy.
Did you, because you swallowed?
Not for me, bro. I'm going to make them. I didn't say I was going to wear them.
Oh, well, okay.
Yeah, I definitely not.
Tangents.com.
Tangents. It's .org,
Net?
Bro. Oh, yeah. We're probably like a .tv. Tangents.info.
Whoa. Okay. Sorry. Where?
So we were baby screaming.
Baby screaming on the airplane.
Okay. It's my opinion
yes.
that parents have been, it's like the cycle of life.
Not the circle of life.
No, the cycle. Because you grow up And as you grow up, you hear babies crying all the time. So you're like, fuck that. This is bullshit, right? And then you become a parent, and then you're like, well, it's just, I'm just going to let everyone else get this because that's how it goes. It's like hazing. Like, you think it's like tradition. Like, it's tradition for my baby to annoy you on a plane because I was annoyed by someone else having a baby on my flight when I was growing up.
I see your point.
I don't agree with it. I think it's bullshit.
Oh, fuck no, I don't agree with
it. I think you muzzle that fucking thing. Well, I have got a better idea. Leave it at home.
Leave it.
Leave the baby on the board in your house.
Leave the baby on the board.
Yeah, like board.
Oh, boy, I thought.
Is it room and board?
I thought you meant like cork board. Like you take some thumbtacks and you pin the fucker to the board.
It's actually how I do it. I do the Zach Galifianakis backpack and just.
The backpack and go boink. Bye, Carlos. Have a great day.
Yeah, that's right, Carlos.
You're welcome glasses. With the glasses.
Oh, fuck. That's great. Okay, so baby screaming.
So what I do is I just bring earplugs, and then I bring the headphones like you have, and I put those over, and they're noise-canceling. And then I'll watch a movie, or I'll play Slayer, or whatever, to try to drown out as much as I possibly can.
How about a baby brought to a movie theater?
Oh,
do you
dear
remember,
God.
Did you ever hear that?
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And I think one of the last Star Wars that I saw.
No.
Yeah, wait for it.
Dude.
Let me. The baby didn't make a peep, dude. The theater was almost empty. There was only probably 12 people in the theater. The theater was almost empty. And then probably like with 4 or 5 minutes to go, the baby goes, wah. And that was it. Like, bah. Yeah. Because the baby thought the baby also thought the movie sucked. So I was like, yes, baby, I agree. There's also one star.
One diaper down.
Yes. Like
diapers down.
Yes.
One diaper down.
Yes. Thumbs down for fuck you, Star Wars. So
you're talking about the newest episode, correct? Or the last one?
I think it was the middle one. The
middle one of the third trilogy.
But I saw that they had the little car seat on the floor, and I was like.
Oh, fuck. That's what I would have been. I would have been like. Fucking done a 180. Gone. I'm gonna. Like, I'd like my money back for another theater. Can you have a babyless theater? They should have babyless theaters.
Well, kind of like cruises and all inclusive resorts.
Cruises don't have babies.
No, they have childless cruises.
Nice.
Like nobody under 16 or nobody under 18, and then they have resorts that are all adult, no kids.
I like those.
So like, why wouldn't you?
It helps with legalities.
Yeah.
And with.
Like, just you can't get on unless you're legal drinking age or da-da-da-da-da, whatever, you know what I'm saying?
It keeps us, yeah, I still have to card, though. 16-year-old could sneak up on board and be like,
hi, Christopher.
And you're like, oh, you must be at least 18, aren't you? I don't know. Just thought about
now
that.
Now bend over.
Whoa. I'm out.
Have you I love seen you, V for Vendetta?
Hi, Megs, I love you. I'm just making jokes. He's like gonna go through with it. So baby crying. That's fucking annoying. And like what's the worst place to have a baby crying? Because on a plane is bad, but I think in a movie theater when you're actually trying to hear some other stuff, like because you can't put headphones on in a theater to hear like.
Agreed.
So like I would think that type of environment would be more.
I absolutely agree.
Okay, good.
You know the good. Best place, dude, when a baby cries?
Church.
Fucking, oh, no. Oh, that's the second best place.
Okay.
Dude, the best place? Fucking Slayer concert. Because you can't hear that little fucker.
Yeah, it's true.
All you hear is raining blood.
And the baby's got the stupid fucking
shooter. Yeah, like they're at fucking
helmet.
NASCAR.
They've got fucking, they've got a shotgun earpieces on, right?
That's all they hear.
Baby at a fucking hockey event.
Yeah, you can.
Hockey game.
Yeah, you can.
Like these big fucking cans, and they're just like,
let's go Flyers. Let's go Flyers. Let's go Doggies. Let's go Doggies.
Oh, I was really liking
that. Let's go Doggies.
That was fucking awesome. All right. Well,
Did
I think
we beat
beaten...
that to death like a horse.
I believe we've beaten that whore to death. So. All right, bro. So my next one.
Please.
Brake squealing.
Ugh.
I can't fuck. Not in my car, because it's muffled with my sound on and stuff, but I mean, like, with the car next to me. But if I'm standing on a corner.
Your brakes are squeaking
and
right
now? And
someone
slows down. No, no, I can't tell. I'm just saying, if I'm in my car and someone's brakes are squealing, not as big a deal. But if I'm on the corner, I hear this.
You need to turn up that volume, dude.
All right, I'll try it a little louder. Let's see. Let's see if this is better. Okay, that's enough. I can't do that.
Yeah, crank it up. Break off the knob.
I'm good, bro.
Okay, that's my brake squeal. I can't. My nipples are hard right now.
is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Well, it just means I'm like it's gone beyond the goosebumps to my nipples.
I'm so perplexed, and I don't give a fuck.
It's all connected, bro. Just know it's all connected.
Okay.
It's like the universe. Everything's
but
connected.
Different.
But
it's,
totally different.
But breaks.
I'm full of shit, everybody. Oh, shit. But yeah, brake squealing. What do you think about brake squealing? How do you feel
I think
about
you
it?
Should fucking go to Midas. If your brakes squeal, fix that shit before your rotors are fucked up.
I think it's time for a trip to Midas. I'm not annoyed by the sound. I just find your callousness with your vehicle maintenance.
Yeah, like there's a reason why there's the fucking sound.
There's a lack of vehicle maintenance, sir.
Well, that means you're probably late on an oil change, and your tires are probably bald, like my dome, and all kinds of other shit. It's a busted ass vehicle.
A BAV?
Yes.
We've got UAVs and BAVs.
All kinds of Vs.
Those busted ass vehicles are awful. So basically almost like 86% of cars in Arizona?
66. Okay. 58.
And if I may, because this is tangents.
Dog.net.
This is tangents, everybody. So hold on 1 second.
Uh oh.
It is tangents. So ladies and gentlemen, Christopher and I are living in pretty much the seventh level of hell right now.
Sixth?
It's 116 fucking degrees the last 3 days. It won't get below 110 until like next Friday. And we have more fucking coronavirus or COVID-19, test things in all of Europe. So you're welcome.
Dude, we're behind Florida today.
Sweet. A different article.
We dropped to number two.
Oh,
behind Florida.
And all the way, you fucking fucks who talked about weather. Oh, yeah, when it gets hot. The three highest fucking rates are Arizona, Florida, and Texas. So, yeah, fucking temperature.
Hey.
Oh, sorry.
Hey, I was one of those people that said that. I did. I was oh, yeah, when it gets hot, shit's going to be like, I'm like, we're going to be back to work in July. Man, so I admit I was totally full of shit, and I apologize.
You know where you messed up?
In saying all that shit.
You said it was going to blow over, right? Not blow up. You just got the over and up wrong. It blew up. It didn't blow over. That's all. You got the blow right. It blew.
That's what she said.
And it blows.
Irregardless, it's fucking hot out.
Fucking super.
This morning on the news, the low temperature this morning at the airport, 94.
It's frigid, sir. It's downright chilly.
I was like, motherfucker.
All right, brother. My friend.
Jace.
My compadre. Mi compadre. Is it time for a shot? Oh, you didn't finish. You're sipping. Sipping. I think you need Mas Tequila, sir.
Mas Tequila.
Okay, and then while I'm pouring, please share your next annoying sound in the world.
Okay, here we go. Because, you know, what's... Well, you know, I have so many here.
I know. We have like a whole three.
I have like nine. I'm trying to
whichever order, man. We'll find it. In the meantime,
I'm gonna have to go with the dinner time.
Already
knows he doesn't see my list and he already knows what I'm gonna say.
Let me guess, it sounds something like this.
No.
Oh, okay. What's it sound like?
It's the knife, the steak knife, and the fork when they hit the plate and they screech.
Oh, on the plate itself.
On the plate itself.
Oh, that's like, that is the worst.
The silverware screeching. Yes.
I didn't get that one, bro. I'm sorry.
I'm not so, you know what I mean? It happens, But there are some people that are notorious screechers.
Extra screechers.
Mega screechers.
May I share a story about
utensil? Fuck yeah,
about
hit the story
utensil.
Time button.
Oh, it's time. When I was growing up with my meemaw.
Meemaw.
My meemaw.
Is that your grandmother?
My grandmother.
Yes.
Now, I was always taught to, like, put my mouth around a utensil, bite down, and slide it off.
Oh,
because,
dear God.
Well, meat's on there. I don't know. Actually, I don't think I was ever taught how to eat. Because, like, I got up to 300 pounds at some point. So
you're lucky to be here because you were never taught how to eat?
So this is what I would do is, with cereal specifically, the spoon, I'd put it in my mouth and bite down. So you'd hear this every time. And I know this is not a spoon, but this is what you'd hear.
Stop it.
My grandma fucking just wham one time out of the fucking like, she's like, stop with that noise. She didn't actually hit me, ladies and gentlemen. She was so sweet. But that must have driven her nuts for like 10 years before she told me. And now I have to go. Now you don't hear it. But I didn't know that I didn't know.
And so that's half the
battle.
That
was annoying. And to your point, there are extra scrapers that like, it's like with if they don't hear it, they're not cutting the food properly.
Do you think that's like a nervous disorder? Like they don't even, that's not the right term, but is there
an idiosyncrasy, like a tick?
Perhaps they don't even
sort.
Know it. Like,
yes, I think so. I think when brought to, when they're shown it, I think people are more receptive to change. Cause I didn't know that I bit down. I didn't even realize the sound I made that like on the metal every
yes,
time.
Yes.
I can't imagine me not knowing didn't bother me, but I could totally see it. Other people going, what the fuck are you doing? So. Yeah, but that one is annoying. That you're talking on the plate, and even though even the in between, just the metal on metal sound sometimes doesn't.
I cannot wait the next time we go out to dinner, dude. I'm gonna annoy the fuck out of you.
Steak 44.
No, like
you're
I
gonna
hope
do it. Steak 44, aren't you? You're gonna spend $100 on a steak just so you can go.
No, we're gonna go tonight to like Red Lobster, and I'm gonna be like. It's gonna.
Do you want to know why I won't hear that?
Because you're going to wear headphones?
All I'm going to hear is the sound of me chewing every cheddar biscuit that comes near my face. Because all you hear is...
You disgusting freak.
And speaking of which, might as well get to that one.
Which one?
The next fucking annoying
sound.
Go
ahead, bro.
Because that sounds like a natural transition now. Would be chewing. I have three.
You never finished story time.
Three. Oh, no, I bit on the spoon until I stopped. Okay. And then my meemaw said, okay, stop doing that. And I said, okay. Oh, yeah, it's over again. Ta! The end. That was the worst story ever.
It was good. Bunk.
So these are ones. Now, the first one is just a normal chewing, but the other two I think are like gum related. Motherfuckers who smack gum.
I thought you meant gum.
Not chewing
like, gum.
Like halitosis related? Oh, gingivitis?
You mean chewing gum.
They got gingivitis?
You mean like Hubba Bubba?
Yeah, like Hubba Bubba or
Bubblicious.
Or
Trident.
Big League Chew.
Oh, yeah.
Tape by the Foot or...
yes.
All Juicy
that
Fruit,
shit.
You name it. But this is the one. This is the regular chew.
Crank it up.
Crank it up. It sounds like some fat motherfucker eating their fucking
like salad,
yeah, or like chips or something, like some kind of dessert. That's just disgusting.
It's like romaine. Yeah.
Bleh.
Is that kale?
I don't know, but that was the one. Okay, so that first chewing sound is just disgusting. But then when you go to these, this is where you really lose my shit. Oh, see, I can even do it quietly. So, and then that's the second one. But then the last one of the three. Oh, no, sir. No, no, don't. Bro.
Yes, bro.
Sir.
Yes.
Oh, God. All right. Well, okay. Do you want to see if you can make it same sound? Okay, let's see. You're dead on, man. That sounds exactly the same. It's so fucking gross. Your turn.
Yeah.
I have a question for you.
Sure.
Ooh, sir. Ooh, I have a question, Mr. Peralta. Mr.
Check
Peralta.
Mark. You have a question.
Yes, sir. Mr. Peralta, why did I record sound when you sound exactly the same?
It's live versus Memrex.
But why do I want to record? I spend all time recording this and downloading. You could have just come in with your fat face and gone,
I didn't have any romaine lettuce with me. I thought I would just bring some gum.
You also do not have fat face. You have a very beautiful face. Thank you. Just say.
It's like, right. It is like bowling ball. It's like 8 pounds. The human head weighs 8 pounds.
Did you know my band?
Shut up, kid. All right, then I've got one more chewer.
Just so we can, I'm done with that.
I spent all that time downloading these. I might as well share them with
fuck yeah, do the it. World.
That
sounds like somebody in the swamp.
Sounds like like a cow chewing cud. Is what that sounds
that's
like.
That's wretched, dude.
Sounds like an X, actually.
Whoa, hey now.
Ew.
Doing what?
It. Oh, I mean chewing gum. All right. What do we got next on your list, sir? What could possibly be better than that?
You know, this actually might be worse. This actually may be further up on my list. It's probably further up than the knife or the baby for me. And I forgot. It popped in my head a few minutes ago. And I don't think this is don't think the people that do this, it's their fault. I think it's an involuntary, it's like a nervous.
Like a Tourette's kind of thing?
Yes, absolutely. Okay. I think it's like someone that picks their nails or like when girls play with their hair, they just don't know they're doing it, right? So a friend of mine I used to work with, and they obsessively clear their throats.
I didn't even think about that one.
Every minute, every 90 seconds. It's very, it's not loud. Their mouth is not open, but.
Is the throat clearing similar to yawning for you? Like if you hear someone clearing their throat, do you feel compelled to clear yours?
Sometimes, yes.
Many times for me. I can't say every time, but just you talking about it right now, I feel like I need to clear my throat and I feel awful about it.
Do you, I got Ricola.
Ricola.
So, it's very challenging for me. It's very quiet, but I will punch you if you do, and I'm not violent. Would you like story time?
I would like story time.
So this shit's so funny, dude. This is like from fucking 25 years ago.
A note to self, we need to set, we need to have a bigger space between story times because we're going back to back story time, which is totally cool.
I'm saving the best story for last. This one came up.
Oh,
bro.
This one's beautiful. Okay, yeah. Ready? Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have an official story time. Are you ready?
Yes. So, like 25 years ago, probably. Look at you, you're frozen. Look at that. That's beautiful. Oh, you are frozen. Not the movie. That's dumb. So that was really good.
I was like, we're still having technical difficulties.
No, I was home from college, I think. And I went over to Abel's house, my best friend, and his mom was there. He's like, hey, man, you want to come and watch a movie? My mom's watching a movie. I'm like, sure. So she has, I don't know if she still does, but at the time, every 90 seconds. And it's not dark out, but the house was kind of dark because we're watching the movie, and I like watching movies in the dark. I don't have a problem with that.
I wouldn't know.
Wait for it. Uh oh, moved your camera, bro.
I know, I screwed a lot of things up right now.
So I said,
this recording's gonna be shit.
It's awesome. So I go after about 15 minutes, maybe. I go, Mrs. P, can I get you a drink of water? Oh, no, thanks, mijo. I'm fine. Thank you so much, though. I'm like, okay.
Mrs. Abel. Just kidding.
I call her Mrs. B. I've known her since, you know, I was fucking whatever.
Yeah, mommy too.
No, like.
I know, but she's like mommy too.
I met her when I was like 14. Anyway, so. So I turned to Abel. like 5 minutes later, I go very, very, very quietly. I go, I have to go. wait. I go, listen, dude, listen. I have to go now.
And he's like, what are you scared of this movie, you fuck?
And then he goes, okay. He didn't. He's like, all right, whatever, yeah. Dude. So he's like, so we walk outside. He's like, what's wrong, bro? He's like, dude. I'm like, dude, what the fuck's wrong with your mom, dude? He's like, what do you mean? He's like, dude, just clear your fucking throat. Every minute. He goes, he didn't, because it's his mom, and he's completely used to it. Not his fault. Yep. He's a great fucking dude. Love him like a brother.
Look, I know it's not HIV or MS or like sclerosis or cerebral palsy, but it's TCS. Throat clearing syndrome. I mean, it's highly, look, it affects more people than the other ones, and it's probably more annoying to everyone else.
So about once every other month.
I'm going to pay for that one.
Sure. Also. Every other month, I get a text message from Abel, and it just says, I have to go now. And it's been 25 years since that fucking story.
Every month?
Every other month.
Oh my God. That's
I'll get a,
I don't have a recurring
dude. Cause it's so, cause I'm just like that. I turn to him and go, I have to go now. I wanted to stab myself in the throat, dude. I couldn't do it. I was like, bitch, my head. I'm like, bitch, get some water.
And when it's like subtle, like,
can I get you a goddamn lozenge? How about a Slurpee? Some hot tea with honey in my head. I'm like, oh my God.
How about leave?
That's why I was like, I had like, and I'm, you know what? I got to go like, and.
That has been story time, ladies and gentlemen. That's a beautiful thing.
I'm exhausted.
But clearing a throat, that is a very annoying one.
Like once is okay.
Yeah.
But that's why, like if you have a.
Ailment.
Get a cough drop.
May I pile on?
Fuck yeah.
My dad drinks nothing but raw milk and is a barber. So let me just share how that works.
Yeah, because I'm perplexed.
Milk. Anyone know
the texture good?
And the consistency of milk and drinking it? It's like sludge, right? Just everything gets caught in the throat. You get mucus.
It's very thick.
Plus, my dad cuts hair. So think about all the little hair fibers that you don't have that like go in the air when he's cutting.
He
breathes that in. So he's got probably like a softball-sized hairball in his lung. And he drinks milk all day. So all yours. He's probably the healthiest guy I've ever met, but it's annoying as all get out.
Holy
poo. He clears his throat all the time. I'll try to record it next time.
No.
And then you look at me and go, I have to never do this podcast ever again. Now.
Dude, I can't meet your dad, bro.
No, you won't. Don't worry.
I love you, man, but no.
I love you too. And the reason you're not going to meet my dad is because I love you, man.
Oh my God.
Why would I want to suscept you? Why would I want to make you susceptible to that? I would never want to inflict that on you, my friend. It's awful.
He needs to wear a mask 30 years ago.
Yep.
Mask up Philly.
All right, bro.
Well.
So we've gone through, I don't even know where we are on the list, but cares? Fuck it. All right. I'm going to save that one for later.
Sure. You do you.
This one's not easy, but because the sound's not that great, but nails scratching on things, on certain things, God. Chalkboards, material. I'm going to try to see if this one comes out okay, but it's not really a good one, I don't think, but.
Oh, God.
Okay, I'm never playing that one again.
That's right. That horrible.
Is, the when it went, that one.
Dude, even when I do it, I remember it, being in school and I would do it and I.
Yep. Even trying to get other people, right? And you're the perpetrator of it and you still get it also. But is the juice worth the squeeze? If you can get five or more people to react the way you react to it, I'll do it.
No.
But if it's only like four or less, no, it's I would not
never
worth
do
it
because I hate it. I hate it so much. I would never do it.
All right. Well, that one we just had bang out.
God. Oh, that has to be. I got to move that up the list, man.
That one is
that's
so
like my number
dissonant.
One or two, dude.
Yeah. Because of the reaction you get.
Yeah.
It's funny because we talk about these things and like some noises are like you freeze. Like, your fight or flight kicks in. That one makes me, like the woodwind sound, that squealing, like I freeze. Whereas some, which we'll get into later, are more like just annoying. They don't make me do anything other than make me want to kill the person doing it.
Like the throat?
Well, yeah, the throat one is a good one. It's not like, it doesn't affect me physically, like the sound, but it's just annoying where I'm like, stop doing that.
Stop talking? Not you.
Oh.
Somebody else that may be annoying you.
I get told to stop talking a lot, so like when anybody says that, I just have to stop. All right. So what's the next one, my friend? You know.
When you go to like a QT or a Circle K or a AMPM or any kind of convenience store and you get a Thirst Buster or a Big Gulp or one of those fucking Polar Pops or some shit.
Yeah.
And it was 32 an ounce or 44 ounce or the old 96er or whatever.
The old 96er. Great Outdoors reference.
You gotta
love that fucking movie.
Gotta eat the gristle. And then
there's nothing on this plate but gristle and fat.
Well.
So.
Another aqua.
Oh, shit.
You did. Daniel, we salute thee. John, you're a dead fat fuck.
Dude, he was awesome.
Man. I tried to out-die him?
Excuse me?
I thought I was going to eat myself death before he did. I thought I was going to die at 42 from a heart attack.
Well, I'm glad that you're skinny and not dead.
Skinny.
And I'm glad you're alive in the room right now.
Do you have one? Okay. Salute. We drink.
Oh, God, I love Patron.
That's in respect to the old 96er, John Candy and Dan. In the Great Outdoors.
So yeah, a big fucking drink. Yeah,
Polar Pop.
Styrofoam.
Big fucker.
Styrofoam
thing.
Drink with the plastic lid with the plastic straw. Yes, sir. And then I'll go. But some people do it in meetings at work. Now, you know, we're not at work right now because of July 2020 COVID. So some people are like, so John, what's the status of that project? And then Betsy's over there going, because she's trying to get it closer to her lips, you know.
What's her name?
I just made that up.
Hey. There's a fucking mute on your Zoom, okay? Well, shut it down.
Which that led me yes, good job, Squealer. So that led me right into a whole shitload of conference call etiquette things, okay. Which I'm like, maybe we don't bring those up and we have a whole conference call.
A
whole podcast.
Us commit to a conference call podcast etiquette.
Yeah, we'll
conference
do that later.
Because look, we did sports and concert events. So yeah. There's etiquette everywhere. Courtesy
or
and respect,
there's
bro.
Lack just of courtesy. Etiquette.
Well, yeah, but let's have a little courtesy.
Anyway, so is the next one.
That one is fucking annoying as fuck.
What do you got, bro? I'm sorry. Dude. Man.
Well, I'm kind of down to my last one.
Stop it.
Yeah. But it's the one. It's the one that is the most annoying to me. And there's caveats to it. It's not 100% annoying. It is contextually annoying.
Contextually?
Yes. What I mean by that is depending on the circumstance, it can be accepted or not accepted.
Okay.
And I'm just going to make the noise.
Uh-oh.
And then we'll go from there. I'm going to do one, and then we'll end with the other one, because I have two of them.
That's your favorite, dude. How is that not your number one, dude?
It is my number one. It makes me want to fucking punch people. Now, I accept it. Obviously, you know the sound. Could you please share with the audience in case we all live under a rock what that sound is?
Slurping a drink?
Thank you.
But is that on there?
Yeah, he'd swallow too. It's
okay,
disgusting.
So the gulping sound.
All of it.
Isn't the gulping sound like your worst enemy nemesis?
Yes. And I'm going to share it because
please.
I want to preface this by saying how much I admire Joe Rogan. I find Joe Rogan to be an amazing individual, that he is just cool. And
yeah.
And congratulations on your deal that you signed with Spotify for $100 million.
Oh.
But his studio is so quiet. When they drink, I hear the swallow every time. And I listen to him and watch his stuff religiously. And all you hear is... because there's no ambient sound. It like absorbs all of it. It's just getting it right from his drink, and he's right there. And it, but it's just an annoying sound. Now, I accept slurp on the first half inch of coffee at the top of a mug when it's super scalding hot. So yes. Like, just because it's super hot, you got to get the cold in there, but you got to get the caffeine in your body. I'll accept that. Like, you just got to get that
when
first.
When it's 5:30 a.m.?
Yeah, you got to prime the pump.
I got to have caffeine. Oh, my God. It's so early. I'm hungover. Holy shit.
Right. But it's like when you got to prime the pump, right? It's like, yeah, I just got to get that first hit. And then after that, then you blow and not constantly. Not none of this shit. This shit is just, this is just not going to do it. That.
Boom.
There was a swallow. Did you hear that swallow at the end of that fucking thing? Oh my God.
I did.
That was annoying, bro. I'm just saying that.
I don't know how we did that.
You have a couple more though, don't you?
I'll
try. Let's see if I can recreate the sound that you hate. Because we don't have any more sound.
Yeah, we do.
We do? Oh, shit.
We'll save that
That's
one
right.
for last.
Yeah, we'll save that That's one for last because I've got a story around that one.
Yeah, you do. Squeaky shoes. And which I, and then the
squeaky shoes, like the, oh, like basketball.
Yeah, or when you're breaking shoes in.
Oh, the crunch, that, yeah. That
yeah.
Expanding sound.
I'm
with you. Yeah, that's annoying.
Also, the super old school alarm clocks.
That one?
That one, as well as the ones from like, the they're, oh. Yeah, where the, there's the two
the hammer?
On.
With the hammer and
yes.
The bells. I could totally see that being annoying AF.
As fuck, totally, as
do you
well.
Know what I, do you know what I had for my alarm clock?
Tell me.
My parents.
So you hate that alarm clock?
I hate all of my alarm clocks because it meant that I had to learn how to speak, read, and write German at like 4 in the morning.
God.
After my dad shoved cod liver oil and warm milk down my gullet at 1:30 in the morning and had me try to go back to sleep without washing it down with anything. Oh, did I meant? Oh, I'm sorry. This isn't a therapy session.
Why don't
session,
you
I'm
lay
sorry.
Down and tell me about this?
Check Why out. Don't you tell me about your parents and then we go to figure out how much you love your mother and how much you want to be with her?
Because isn't that what Freud
Sigmund
always did?
Freud.
Yeah, that was my Freud, bro. That was a pretty good Freud.
Good thing we both want to punch our moms, so Sigmund Freud.
I don't want to punch my mom, man.
Do you
want to
punch my mom?
Mom, I don't want to punch you. And you didn't wake me up like that.
But your Faja did.
My Faja.
The Faja.
He's like.
The Mudja and the Faja.
Faja.
He's oh, my the Faja. Father.
I don't speak fricky dicky Dutch. I'm Ooh. Sorry, I don't speak free. Oh, this it's for the skin box. Oh,
this one's
for
a
skin box. This one's a keeper for the skin box. Oh, yes. Oh, gold.
So that, yeah, that's the other one. Okay, squeaky shoes.
Let me make sure I've covered
an alarm clock. That's a good one, the alarm ring. May I ask you a question?
Yes, sir.
Is it annoying to you? Because the alarm ring and the old school phone ring is annoying to me also. Remember the old school phone ring?
Hello, what's my
What's more
job?
Annoying? Is that motherfuckers put that ring as their ringtone for like a new phone, like their old fangly, and I just want to slap the fucking phone out of their hand. Don't tell me you have that.
That's
bro.
Right. Because I'm a phone guy, dude.
I know.
But I also don't I want like the...
But you're a telecommunications master. You can do whatever you want with a phone. Like you're the master of your
yeah,
own domain.
Yeah, okay. But my
Yes. Bring the phone to me.
But the point is, I don't want like my, I get so many spam calls like, right. Hi, would you like us to buy your house? I got yesterday. Would you like to buy your house in Scottsdale? I have never lived in Scottsdale in my entire fucking life. And I don't now, you fucking motherfucker. Sorry, I cuss too much. Catholic school, not my fault.
be... Would you like to be on the couch this time?
Yeah, I would like very much to be on the couch and talk about the fact that I get many solicitations. And that accent, I have no idea what it is.
It's many countries.
It's like Czech and Russian.
It's like everything.
And...
Everything together.
It's like the EU, bitches.
If the whole world fucked itself,
yes.
You'd have Christopher.
So... I get so many solicitations about, hey, would you like solar? No. Would you like to replace your windshield? No. Would you like car warranty? No. So I get so much spam on my phone. I don't want to put my favorite song on there, and then I'll get tired of it.
May I?
Yes.
May I try something? May I share?
Yes. Because
you know how to do settings and stuff on your phone? I know nothing about settings, so maybe you can help me program mine. I want every unknown phone that's not in my phone to say... Just literally, the ringtone would be, don't answer. And that's all it says. Just one time, don't answer, and I'll know, oh. And every unknown phone, I think you can set unknown phones. Phones not in contact have X ringtone.
I understand what you want to do. I would have to beer Google it.
And... Be like, shut the fuck up, or something, or mail, motherfucker. It'd be like, phone, motherfucker. Then you just know it's like bullshit. But I think I could hear phone motherfucker all the time from like Eurotrip.
Yeah.
Mail, motherfucker.
Yeah.
That shit makes me chuckle very funny. All the time.
It's very funny.
What other sounds you got? What else you got? How many more? Let's bang them out because we got other shit to talk about.
That is all, sir.
That's it?
Yes, sir.
No, you have one more.
Negative.
Okay.
I do have a story about your last one.
Oh, okay. So we're going to...
Do you remember what I did to you?
I do.
Okay.
Because you sent it to me on your via text, you bastard.
No, I did not.
You didn't?
No.
What did you do?
I sent it to you. Not via text.
When did you send it?
I sent it to you.
Via email?
No. You want to just do story time?
Let's tell
the sound.
Well, I'm gonna share the sound and my story, because my story about who I looked up, remember that? Creepy fucking connection there, synchronicity people. Knocked consciousness coming into the beer Google.
Ruh-roh.
All right. So this is the last one, sir. You can tell me what you think this is. Okay. All I hear is, you son of a bitch. We have to go to the hospital now because Chris just choked trying to make a funny.
I just inhaled my Powerade. I'm so sorry.
So, nail clipping.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Clipping of the nails. Is this the contextual reference?
Yeah, no, that the contextual was the slurp.
Okay, the coffee.
Yeah, the top half inch of hot coffee can be slurped.
Okay.
After that, swallow that shit and let it burn your goddamn gullet. That's the way that shit goes.
Woo! All
right, nail clipping. Yes. Now, my old job at which you and I both worked.
Yes.
One guy notorious, all you hear, and like middle of the day.
Lee?
Now, yeah.
How did I know that?
Middle of the day. We're not.
I just, it is Lee. It was a good guess. There's a thousand people there.
It was a fucking perfect
guess. There's a thousand people there, and I had one,
because the guy's such a fucking dumpster fire, that's why.
God bless him.
Motherfucker would clip his nails. Now, all I hear when I hear the sound of nail clipping is the sound of dead skin cells with dirt and shit under them flying around the room. That's all, like, that's the visual. I don't know how the visual is, but it's like all dead cells with dirt.
And all I hear is the Sepultura song, Dead Embryonic Cells.
Ooh.
That's all I hear. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Please.
That's all I hear.
Hello. We are Tangents, Interruptibles, and like, let's fucking jump
Interruptibles.
In here. Now, one of my favorite Bob Saget jokes is, a fart is like a guy shitting in your hand. I'm only using in this reference.
I'll approve. Okay.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
I should have pre-approved.
No, it's fine.
Sorry.
Pre-approval.
But I'll say, you say, a fart is like someone shitting in your hand and going, and blowing it on you.
That's true.
Nail clippings are the farts in physical manifestation form after clipping them, because they go on all different... You have no control over the direction
correct.
Which dead cells with dirt and shit under them go.
That's correct.
I still wouldn't accept... Even if you scrubbed your hands before, it's still dead cells everywhere, and it just freaks me out. I don't know why. Something about it. And the sound. And my new job, someone did it. Thank God they quit. So my last two big jobs, but this is the story time, sir.
Yes, sir.
Are you ready for the story time?
Yes.
That was a slurp.
Oh, no. Hit the button.
I'm trying. In junior high, I had a teacher. He was a math teacher. His name was Dr. Ira Lee Riddle. Yeah, that's right. Ira Lee. And it's funny. Both people who cut their nails that we just talked about have Lee
in their name.
Holy fuck.
Boom.
That's even bigger. That's a mic drop moment. So Dr. Ira Lee Riddle was a fat guy. And I'm not trying to disrespect the guy, but he was a big dude. And he rode his bike to work every day.
Bicycle.
And he would, yeah, bicycle, not motorcycle. He would come in just like drenched because he was, and he was a chess player. He was like the president of the Philadelphia Chess Association. He's a pretty heady dude. Really smart guy.
Heady.
So he would come in, and in between classes, he'd take off his shoe, off his sock, and you'd roll. He'd roll out his black sock.
In between classes?
Between classes. Like when you're switching classes, okay. Like, you know, like bell between rings and you got
fifth period.
Yes. You got 15 minutes to get over to your whatever class. So we'd walk in with him just unrolling his like fucking fat digit feet and just. Right. So Monday, July 6th, that pops into my head. I'm like, holy shit.
Like
Dr. Ira Lee Riddle's going to be
6 days ago.
6 days ago. But July 6th is specific. So I'm downstairs with Megs, and I'm like, oh my God, this my one teacher clipped his fucking nails in between class, his toenails. He'd fucking pull his socks off and his shoes. It's disgusting. And I'm like, huh, I wonder what happened to him. I wonder where he's at. He's probably dead, but I'll check because he was a big guy. I figured he died already. So I look. He died. Would you like to guess when he died?
June 6th.
July 6th,
oh,
sir.
I was off by a month.
He died 11 years to the day that I looked him up. To the day. That's a 1 in 365 chance.
That's sir. Pretty...
That's fucked up.
Pretty accurate.
It was pretty fucked up. But that was my boring story time. But I know you have a story time. We don't have to hit, do we have to hit it again?
Yeah, because one ended and one begins.
It is over. My story time is over. I looked up Dr. Ira Lee Riddle. Mad props. Sorry you're resting peacefully in heaven or wherever you are, Dr. Ira Lee Riddle. But I looked him up 11 years to the day he died. That was just weird. Weird.
That's freaking weird.
Well, now, I think it's Chris's time.
We need a little harp.
Oh, we need the actual physical?
Yeah, like
a plastic
little baby
one from the dollar store?
Okay. Yes.
I'll look for one.
The Amazon store.
We're going to have way too many fucking stupid props lying around here by the time this is all
said. Big deal. We already got a damn toenail clipper.
Well, that's because I was cutting my nails, but outside, not and before you got here, sir.
Thank the gods. So
hold on, let me do it while you're telling the story.
I don't care. This fine gentleman, check mark, I'm going to guess 2005, so 15 years ago. He tells me his huge pet peeve is when people cut their toenails. Oh, I'm sorry, their fingernails at work. So the next Monday, I go to my desk before anybody gets in. It's like six. He forgets the story till I start prefacing it.
Oh,
he
shit.
Forgot I did this.
Oh, I forgot.
He forgot.
I totally forgot.
And this... I did this to somebody else. I did it to Renee as well because she also hated it probably more than you.
Maybe.
If I remember correctly, I sent this. Let me finish the story and then I'll circle back on that. Because I'm the phone guy. I was like the senior manager, associate director of telecom and a couple other things. So I take the phone off the hook. I lay it on my desk. I dial into the voicemail system. It says, if you'd like to record a message, press 2. Beep. I then put my fingers to the mouthpiece of the handset. And I clip all 10 fucking fingernails.
I totally forgot about that.
Press pound when you're done recording your message. Pound. To send your message now.
Don't you mean hashtag?
Fuck yeah, pound. So, hashtag pound. Hashtag pound, bitches. So, please dial the person.
You're such a bastard.
Please dial the number of the person you're trying to fucking call. If you don't
you
know
mean
the
annoy?
Please, if you'd like to send your toenail clipping message now, press 7. Beep. Message has been sent. If you'd like to send it to somebody else, press 3. Beep. Send to Renee. Boop. Thank you so much. Fucking hang that shit up. And then I laughed my ass off for like 9 minutes.
Until you got a call from me.
And then, motherfucker, what is on? I can't believe, like, dude, you can't tell me you hate it when people clip their nails at work. Because I'm going to send you a voicemail of nothing but nail clipping sound. Because I'm dumb.
Well, now I
know
what
shit like that. I do shit like that all the time.
Oh, yeah.
Please. It's kind of like turkey burger, but different.
It's exactly like turkey burger, but totally different.
It's just like turkey burger.
That was probably one of the best. That's my favorite prank, I think, of all time.
Turkey burger or nail clippings?
No, nail clippings. Because there's no collateral damage. One of the things I hate about pranks is that, like, when they fucking saran wrap your desk, office, or do some shit. Now you have to fucking straighten it all out. And it's like, fuck you, assholes. Clean your own shit up.
The only collateral damage was, like, the 3 KB used on the voicemail server, which you then deleted in light speed.
And gave it back. I reattached those 3 KBs.
Like, resent to
dick face. Twitter world.
It is, hello, Twitter world. That would be a kilobyte.
So... I do remember that. You're fucking. That was hilarious.
I can't believe
best.
You forgot that.
I totally forgot.
I thought for sure you were going to remember. I was going to tell that story.
I totally forgot.
The nail clipping thing.
I totally forgot, man. I'm sorry.
I do dumb shit like that.
We do
all
dumb
the time.
Shit. I love it, and I love you for it, bro.
How can I not?
And hello, everyone out there. Please, like, if I may, I'm going to take a step back.
Sure.
That's been story time, and it's why I love you, because like. You're creative, and it's just so fucking.
Who
mean.
Else sends voicemails to people? Like, I don't even call people. The phone. Like, somebody will be sitting.
I don't even leave voicemails for people I want to talk to.
Nobody even checks their voicemail, right? So you don't even have to call the phone. Like, someone will be sitting at their desk, and the voicemail light goes bunk,
bink, like a hotel room light.
How the fuck did they? How did you the thing with the phone? And
especially the internal ones.
With a voicemail, how did you do that? Because I'm smart, and you can do that. Everyone has that ability, but nobody thinks about it.
Yes.
Ta-da, fuckers.
Well, thank you. No, I remember that now. Holy fuck. I was so mad.
And nobody was there, so nobody heard me doing the message. That's the whole point, is I didn't piss off anybody. Because I know there's probably 1 in 20 people hate it as much as you do. And it's inappropriate.
As much as I do, but most people are annoyed at work, especially at work.
No, you should not do that in a work environment. It's not appropriate.
I agree.
You know, even like some guys do it in the gym locker room, and that's questionable too. Because then a gym employee has to come through and vacuum. It's gross, dude.
It's disgusting.
Dude,
like, leave
your
dead cells with dirt under them at home.
Yeah, do it in your house,
like,
man.
When you're walking and your fucking dick is out at in the locker room because you got out the shower, at least you're clean. Like, all the grime that's
on
you
about when you're,
got washed down the drain. But when you're clipping nails, there's still stuff under there.
But what about
and that stuff's getting exposed.
What about when you're naked and your dick's hanging out and you're walking to the shower?
Well, there's kind of not much you can do about that.
But
it's
take
part of the
rabbit tail around you.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, I don't like this guy. The guy with his leg up.
Let's not
this
talk
move.
About, let's, yeah.
This is the visual audio version.
You're being blocked, bro.
Which way do I have to go? This way?
Towards me, dude.
Hey, man. Hey, here's my dick.
Here's my sack.
Hey, man, and I'm naked, and I just got out of the gym. Hey, can I talk to you, bro?
No.
Yeah, don't talk to me, bro. Just put on clothes.
Hey, man, how much are you winning? Put your sack away, sir.
Well, on that note, I think we had way too much fun with that, because, like, you and I come up with the craziest shit, but misophonia, it's a real thing, boys and girls. Can we ask the world? Can we ask our people?
Twitter world?
We are officially over 300 downloads as of now. So
we're
thank
crazy.
You. I want to say thank you so much. Like, we're just having fun with this, and we would love this to be something, but we're just having fun, and we're just glad that people are tuning in at times.
Yes.
But the second step, the thing I need to ask of our listeners, please engage. What is a fucking annoying sound to you? Leave some comments, right?
Yeah.
Tell us. Tell us your 10 favorite movies and the stupidest shit we do or whatever. Like, that's what we want. We want you guys to engage, because we're not just talking to talk. Of course we are. But, you know what I mean.
Yeah. Also.
Yes.
I want to rock.
I want to rock. Yeah. That's Hematite,
you won't
my
get that on the iTunes, but you'll get it on the YouTube.
That's Hematite.
I want to rock.
Christopher's holding a piece of Hematite. It was gifted to me
all
by
the Hematites.
Else. All of them. You know, when they left Egypt, when the Hematites left?
Yeah. What happened then?
They got, I don't know.
Verse 7. Wrap it up, bro.
All right. Well, that has been misophonia and you. Wait, what's the thing from Fight Club? I am Jack's misophonia. I am Jack's ears. I can't stand listening to these sounds.
Uh-oh.
Oh, shit.
We should have done that at the beginning. We should
have
done that.
I should have been like, hey, you want to hear the most annoying sound in the world? Ka-chunk. Well, this has been Beer Googgles, everybody.
Oh, that's great.
We're going to have, what's our next episode about Beer Googgles? About 10 something?
10 movie scenes, I think. Right?
That we like. Let's not say best because it's subjective for sure.
Well, they are the best because mine has Revenge of the Nerds in it.
Oh, shit.
Obviously.
Well, that's a pretty good one.
I know this.
Well, let's get the fuck out of this one so we can get into that one. All right. Well, thanks so much for joining us for Beer Googgles, everybody. This has been Misophonia and You. I think we got all those covered. Do we miss the sound?
Do you think we covered them all?
Oh shit, that shit is just so good, man. I love you, man.
Oh, Tambien.
That was beautiful.